So welcome back to the lecture series of function of complex variable. So in the previous lecture, actually I have discussed if analytic function fz is given to us and we know the real part of that analytic function, then I need to determine the imaginary part of that analytic function, that is called as the harmonic conjugate of the given real part. So in the previous lecture, I have discussed actually one method through which we can determine the harmonic conjugate. So here we are going to discuss the second method to determine the harmonic conjugate. So here fz is u plus iv, that is an analytic function given to us, but v is not known to us, u is known. So it is not so that only u, if u is given we can determine v, if v is given then also we can determine u. So here u is given, suppose u is given, then we need to determine the value of v, that is the corresponding harmonic conjugate. So since fz is analytic, so already we know that the real and imaginary part of the analytic function will satisfy the Cauchy-Riemann equation. So we know that del v del x is equals to minus del u del y. Now since u is given, we know the value of del u del y. So from that, we will integrate v with respect to x keeping y constant. So if we do so, so vxy will be the integration of del u del y with respect to dx plus the constant will be phi of y. Since here we are integrating with respect to x, so the integrating constant will not be a constant, but this will be a function of y. Because if you reversely differentiate, it will get the if we differentiate the integral value, then you will get the derivative. If we differentiate this with respect to x, v with respect to x, you know that phi y being constant, because it is not a function that contains x, so it will be 0. So that's why whenever you will differentiate or you will integrate some function of x to y by keeping some variable fixed, then the integrating constant will be in terms of that variable. So now vxy equals to say fxy, where fxy is the value of the integral, that is minus del u del y dx plus phi y. So that is our required result that we are getting from here. Now differentiating partially y, differentiating this with respect to y, we will get that del v del y will be equals to del f del y plus phi dash y. Now we know that we have used one equation of shear, one equation from shear equations. So we know the second equation. So as per the second equation, we know that del v del y equals to del u del x. Now del u del x is known to us, and this value of del v del y is known to us. So just we can substitute the value of del v del y from here to here. So we can substitute the value of del v del y from 3 to 4. Then it will be converted to del f del y plus phi dashed y equals to del u del x. So del f del y is known to us, del u del x is known to us, so from that we can evaluate the integrating constant, that is phi dash y. So if we substitute the phi, by integrating phi dash y, we can get the value of phi y. So if we substitute the value of phi y here, so from 2 we will get the value of vxy. So this is the second method through which we can determine the harmonic conjugate v of u. So I am giving one example, then I think it will be clear to all of you. So yeah, we need to show that this given function is harmonic and we need to find out its corresponding harmonic conjugate. So similarly, we'll do the partial differentiation of uxy with respect to x. So you know how to differentiate with respect to x partially. So we'll keep this constant, then we'll differentiate this partially with respect to x. Then we'll keep this constant and differentiate this with respect to x partially. So then ux is this, uxx is this, then uy is this, and if we differentiate this with respect to y again, we'll get this. Now if we add uxx plus uyy, we will get that all the terms will be deducted. So this value will be 0. So obviously u is harmonic here. So since u is harmonic, so we can determine its corresponding harmonic conjugate. So how to determine that? So as per the previous discussion, del v del x will be equals to minus del u del y. So minus del u del y is known to us. So we'll substitute this value. Then we'll integrate this with respect to x partially. So vxy will be integration of this. So while we'll integrate this, so we'll keep y as constant, plus integrating constant will be phi y, since we are integrating with respect to x. So now if we integrate this, so if we integrate this, the cos y will be fixed. Then we can integrate minus x e to the power x, so we can use an integration by parts. And similarly here also this term will be constant, so we can use so this y into sin y will be constant, so e to the integration of minus e to the power x we need to do. Then for second one, for third term also, the cos y will be constant and we need to integrate e to the power minus x with respect to x. So by integrating this value or integrating that function, we are getting this value. So now we need to differentiate this with respect to y partially. So if you differentiate this y partially, we will get this result, that means phi dash y. So you know that dv dy from the second equation of Cauchy-Riemann equations, we will get that dv dy equals to du dx. So what is du dx? So from here I am getting du dx. So just I will substitute this. So here we can find this term will be deducted, this term will be deducted, and this term will be deducted. So all the terms from the left hand side and right hand side will be deducted. So phi dash y will be 0. So phi y will be c. So that means we have got the value of phi y. So just we need to substitute the value of phi y here to get the corresponding harmonic conjugate. So by using 2, we will get the harmonic conjugate at this. So corresponding analytic function will be u plus I into v. So whenever we will use the first method, so there is no actually specific form of the problem where we can use the first method or where we can use the second method. So any method you can use as per your choice. So there is no specific reason or specific cause or specific some rules behind choosing any method out of these two methods. So you can choose any methods out of these two methods as per your choice. So in this lecture I have discussed the second method through which we can determine the harmonic conjugate of a given function by combining which we can frame a analytic function. So thank you all for watching this lecture. So stay tuned for the next lecture.